Hello students, today we will solve some problems on resolution and composition of forces. Let me take the first question and next we are going to read the question. Okay. Find the magnitude and direction of resultant of the following system of forces. First force 4 Newton due north. Second 3 Newton acting northwest towards the point. Third, 1.5 Newton acting due east. Fourth, 1 Newton 30 degree west of south away from the point. And last, 5 Newton acting 60 degree north of west away from the point. It means in this question, they have not given the diagram, but they have given you some instructions here with the directions of forces and the value of forces. And they are telling you to find magnitude and direction of resultant. Here we have to calculate what is the resultant, its value, and we have to also locate the resultant. So we will start with this problem. First, I will write the data for this. In this problem, whatever data is given, I will draw it in the form of a diagram. First, let me see here. 4 Newton force is due north. 4 Newton force is due north. So let me draw the diagram for this. Whatever data is given, we will convert it into a diagram. In this case, I will mark the directions. Since here they have given you the directions in the form of north, south, east and west, so instead of writing x and y axis, I will write the directions. Here I will be marking . Let us see the first force. 4 Newton due north. It means the force will be here. It will be acting in the north direction. So here I have 4 Newton force. Second, 3 Newton acting northwest towards the point. 3 Newton is acting northwest. What is the meaning of northwest? Here I have north, here is west. So in between them, that is the angle between north and west is 90 degrees. So you have to take exactly half of that, means 45 degree. At 45 degree we have a force, and the value of force is 3 Newton, and it is acting towards the point. Towards the point means it is acting, you can say, towards the origin. Okay. And the value is 3 Newton. Inclination is 45 degree with horizontal as well as vertical. Then 1.5 Newton acting due east. 1.5 Newton acting due east. Then 1 Newton 30 degree west of south away from the point. 1 Newton hai aur 30 degree west of south. Here I have south, this is east of south, this is west of south. So 30 degree to the west of south. Yes, it is 30 degree to the west of south, means it will be somewhere here. Okay, and what is it? It is away from the point. Away from the point. The value of the force is 1 Newton. 1 Newton, it is at 30 degree. 30 degree to the west of south. Then 5 Newton acting 60 degree north of west away from the point. The direction is north of west. Here I have north, okay. Here I have west and south. So north of west will be on this side, north of west, and inclination is 60 degree. So it will be like this. Value of force, it is 5 Newton acting 60 degree north of west away from the point. It is acting away from the point. value is 5 Newton. So this is the diagram which we have from the data which they have given. Here I have to calculate the value of resultant, that is the magnitude of resultant, and then I have to calculate the inclination, means location of resultant. So now we will solve this problem. How to solve this problem? First of all, you have to convert all the forces which they have given, even if they are inclined forces. You have to convert all the inclined forces into horizontal and vertical components. Here I have horizontal component, which is 1.5 Newton. It will remain as it is. 4 Newton is vertical, that will remain as it is. Now if we talk about this 5 Newton, it is inclined at 60 degree to horizontal. So this 5 Newton will be resolved. I am going to resolve this 5 Newton force, and if I am resolving, I will get my horizontal component as, it will be force which is 5, angle is 60 degree, so I have to write down cos 60 degree. Vertical component, that will be 5 sine 60 degree. After this, here I have 3 Newton force at 45 degree, but the thing is, it is acting towards a point. So here I will be marking its horizontal component and its vertical component. Since it is inclined at 45 degree with horizontal, value is 3 Newton, so I will write down 3 cos 45. And for this vertical component, I am just writing it as 3 sine 45 degree. Then 30 degree, at 30 degree you have 1 Newton force. Inclination is with respect to vertical. So this horizontal component will be 1 sine 30 degree. Vertical component will be 1 cos 30 degree. With this much data, where we have, you can say, so resolve the components into horizontal and vertical form. Now we can easily start with the problem, that is the calculation of resultant. I hope you all have understood this. So I'll write the solution for this problem. I can write down, since the sum of all horizontal forces, since the sum of all horizontal forces is given by summation of Fx, and here the convention is positive forces, that is towards right, the forces should be taken as positive, forces towards left should be taken as negative. Now we will write summation Fx. So therefore, summation of Fx is equal to, here I have 1.5 Newton towards right, positive, then 5 cos 60 towards left, negative, then 3 cos 45 towards right, positive, 1 sine 30 towards left, negative. So here I have all the forces which are horizontal forces. Therefore, if I calculate the value, my summation of Fx comes out to be, here I have the answer which I have already calculated. It is 0.621 Newton. Answer is positive. Therefore, you have to show it towards the right side. I hope you all are getting this. Then I will write also the sum of all vertical forces, sum of all vertical forces are given by summation of Fy is equal to, upward forces are taken as positive,
downward forces, they are taken as negative. So therefore, I can say summation of fx, or here I have fy, that will be equal to, here I have 4 Newton force which is acting upwards, so I will take it as positive. 5 sin 60, that is upward, so positive. 3 sin 45, downward, so negative. 1 cos 30, downward, so negative. 2. So in totality, here I have 1, 2, 3 and 4, 4 vertical forces. So therefore, if I calculate all the values, I will get my summation of Fy is equal to, my answer is 5.34 Newton. Since it is positive, it means it is acting in the upward direction. Next, after this, I can calculate the resultant. I can easily get the resultant. We know the formula of resultant. I can write it down. Now, since resultant is given by capital R is equal to square root of summation fx whole square plus summation fy whole square. Therefore, R is equal to square root of summation fx. The answer which I have got of summation fx is 0.621 Newton. So, it is 0.621 whole square plus summation fy is 5.34 whole square. Therefore, my answer of resultant, if I calculate this entire term, my answer comes out to be 5.38 Newton. My answer comes out to be 5.38 Newton. With this, I have got my first answer. After getting the value of resultant, now we will find the location of resultant. I can write down, since location of resultant is given by, location of resultant is given by theta is equal to tan inverse summation fy upon summation fx. We will highlight this. Therefore, theta is equal to tan inverse of summation fy, the value was 5.34. Summation fx 0.621. If I calculate theta, my answer will be 83.37 degree. That is with respect to horizontal. So this is my second answer. After getting resultant and its location, we can easily show the resultant on a diagram. Let me represent it. Here the directions were given in the form of north, south, east, west. Inclination is 83.37, and if you look at this question, here when we had solved, summation fx was positive, summation fy was positive. So summation fx is positive, it means it is along horizontal positive side. Summation fy positive means it is along the vertical side. So it means resultant will be in the first quadrant and its inclination is 83.37 degree. Value of this resultant, it was 5.38 Newton. So in this problem, we have calculated the resultant and even shown its location. So this completes the solution to the problem.
Since location of resultant is given by theta is equal to tan inverse summation fy upon summation fx. Therefore, theta is equal to tan inverse summation fy, fy was 5.34, summation fx 0.621. If we calculate this value, theta will be 83.37 degree with respect to horizontal. So, this is my second answer. Next, we can even locate the resultant by drawing the axis. In this problem, they have given us axis in the form of north, south, east and west directions. So, we can mark north, south, east and west and then locate the resultant. Inclination is 83.37 degree. So, theta value I have found out. So, I can show the inclination of resultant at 83.37 degree and the value of resultant is 5.38 Newton. And with this, we have completed the first problem. Now, let us take the next problem.